Hear the word of the Lord, ye rulers of Sodom, and give ear to the law of our God, ye people of Gomorrah. To what purpose is the multitude of your sacrifices unto me, saith the Lord? I am full of your burnt offerings of rams and fat and fed beasts, and I delight not in the blood of bullocks and lambs and he-goats. You see, the sacrifice represents praise. Bring a sacrifice of praise to the Lord. Incense represents prayer. And on that altar, incense was poured so that you could smell that odor that of incense all over Jerusalem, filled and wafted through the air. And God said, it's a stench in my nostrils. He said, I don't want to see this blood sacrifice anymore because your heart's not in it. Your heart's not in it. He said, you come in haphazardly. He said, where did you get the idea? You could come in, make your sacrifice, and then just tramp around my court nonchalant like a tourist. They trampled because they came in. If you had looked at them, they would look religious. It looked fine, but there was sin in their lives, and they come in. The picture of it is people coming today into the house of God, habitually bound by sin, have no heart for God, don't even want to be delivered, but still go through the religious traditions. And God says, I will not accept this kind of sacrifice. And I wonder how much of the praise God is receiving, or rather he should send prophets and say, listen, you can't draw nigh to me unless you want to be cleansed, unless you want the Holy Ghost to mortify your sins, unless your mind and your heart is in it. How many of us today, and I say it lovingly, how many of us came into this church today with your mind set on the Lord as you worshiped and as you praised him? Was your mind somewhere else this morning? Did your mind wonder, did you come in and trample his courts this morning? Did you tread on his courts? And God says, what makes you think you can do that? How dare you come into my presence? And he's saying this through the prophet. How dare you, when you come to appear before me, who's required? Who allowed you to think this way, that you could tread my courts? That you could just come any way you please? You say, well, God ought to be pleased that I'm here. As far as God's concerned, you are not here. You're wherever your mind is. God spoke this to me years ago. It's very, very important when you come into his presence to keep focused on who he is and why you're there. To be focused on him. If your mind wanders, go out and do your thing and come back when you're at your best. Because God says, I want your very, very best. Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near to me with their mouth and with their lips, they honor me, but they have removed their heart far from me, and their fear toward me is taught by the precept of men. And they seek to hide their counsel from the Lord, and their works are done in the dark. He said, you know, the night before they do these things in the dark when nobody sees, and then they come into my house without cleansing. They walk right into my presence, and their heart isn't even with me. Jesus took these words of Isaiah and applied them to his generation. Listen to what Jesus said to the Pharisees and scribes. You hypocrites, well did Isaiah's prophesier say of you, this people draweth nigh unto me with their mouth, and they honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. And Jesus saying, Isaiah was talking about you. He wasn't talking about his people alone. He said, this is dual prophecy. He's talking about you. We could do the same thing. We can take what Jesus said today, and we could say to any hypocritical person who believes they can come into the house of God and just say, I went to God's house. I saw his face. I drew near to God. I spent 2 hours at church, and I worshiped with the people. How did you come here? Did you come with deeds done in darkness, that you didn't come to him for cleansing? You didn't come here for power over sin. You came here to ease your conscience, to do a religious thing. And God said, I won't accept that. Won't have it. Let us draw nigh with a true heart and full assurance of faith. Come with a true heart. Come with nothing hidden. You want to come and have God expose everything that's in your life and say, God, here it is. I'm not hiding anything. I come to meet you. Now, Lord, expose it and then give me the power to deal with it. And he's promised to do just that. Blessed is the man whom thou choosest and causest to approach unto thee, that he what may what? Dwell in thy courts. We shall be satisfied with the goodness of thy house, even of thy holy temple. If you've been feeling a pull, I can't explain to you how strong that pull is in my heart this past year. But if you feel that pulling to draw nigh to the Lord as never before, you have a hunger and a thirst, and you're not satisfied with what you have so far, and you know there's so much more. That is God choosing you. He said, I will cause you to draw near to me. I'll cause you. It'll not be a struggle to you now. Folks, if you have that, rejoice in it. That's the Lord fulfilling this very prophecy. He's chosen you because he put that hunger, he put that thirst in you. There are many, many Christians. They're satisfied with just going to church and a little devotion a day. That's all they want, and they're happy with it. And they'll probably be saved if their heart's sincere. But there are others. The Lord said, no, I'm going to put a hunger in you. I'm going to put a thirst in you like you have never known. And this is the way you know that I have put my hand on you and I've chosen you and I'm causing you to draw nigh to me. Because I've got something for you in the way of a walk with me that so few have known. I'm going to lead you and guide you, and the words that you speak